All right, good day everyone, welcome back to Surfax Learning Channel. For today's video, another video lesson for General Physics 1, ang pag-uusapan po natin, which is all about electric flux and Gauss's law. Our learning target for this video lesson is to calculate electric flux and to use Gauss's law to infer electric field due to uniformly distributed charges on long wires, spheres, and large plates, and to solve problems involving electric charges, dipoles, forces, fields, and flux. Now, what is electric flux? Electric flux is a measure of the flow. Take note for that. Measure of the flow of electric field through a surface. It is equal to the product of an area element and the perpendicular component of integrated over a surface. Mathematically expressed as phi times electric flux is equal to E and A, where E is electric field and A is area, or denoted by phi and E, which means electric flux, which is equal to E, which is electric field times the area. Now, if the area is tilted by an angle of theta, therefore your electric flux is electric field times area cosine theta. Again, if the area is tilted. Our phi here is the Greek word phi. If the electric field lines will pass through a surface when it plays to parallel to electric field, or if the electric field is equal to zero, or there is zero flux, therefore your electric flux is equal to electric field times area cosine 90 degrees. Okay? Now, if there is a maximum electric field lines of force passes through a surface when it is placed perpendicular to the electric field, therefore your electric flux is equal to electric field times area cosine theta. To show or to demonstrate it, for perpendicular electric field and maximum electric flux, you have electric field times area cosine theta, and for parallel electric field or zero electric flux, you will use electric field times area cosine 90 degrees. In here, we have three figures to show. Letter A, surface is face on to electric field. So this is our surface which face on to electric field. Our electric field lines are here, horizontal field lines. And our electric field and area are parallel to each other. And therefore, your electric flux is equals to zero. Or your theta, rather, is equal to zero. And therefore, your electric flux is equals to electric field times the area. In figure B, surface is tilted from a face-on orientation by an angle theta. At this point, you have here an angle theta, and the angle between, which is the angle between your electric field and area. So this is your electric field and this is your area, and this is now your angle theta. And your electric flux is equal to electric field times area cosine of your angle theta. Figure C, the surface in edge on the electric field. Both vectors E and A, or electric field and area, are perpendicular. So this is your electric field perpendicular to the area, vector A. Therefore, your theta here is equals to 90 degrees. Pag sinabi natin perpendicular, of course, the angle is equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, your electric flux is equal to electric field times area cosine 90 degrees, which is equal to zero. Now, in connection with this, let's talk about Gauss or Gauss's law. Gauss's law is an alternative to Coulomb's law, while completely equivalent to the Coulomb's law. Gauss's law provides a different way to express the relationship between electric change and electric field. So, Gauss's law provides relationship between electric charge rather than and electric field. And it was formulated by Carl Friedrich Gauss, one of the greatest mathematicians of all times. His law states that the total electric flux through any closed surface, such that a surface enclosing a definite volume, is proportional to the total net electric charge inside the surface. For instance, you are given a field of a single positive point charge Q. The field lines radiate out equally in all directions. We place this charge at the center of imaginary spherical surface with radius R. And the magnitude E of the electrical field at very point on the surface is given by ito. Electric field is equals to permittivity space on air. At each point on the surface, vector E is perpendicular to the surface, and its magnitude is the same at every point. And the total electric flux is the product of the field magnitude E and the total area, which is equal to 4 pi r squared. And the sphere is presented as this. And the flux is independent of the radius r of the sphere. Depends only on the charge enclosed by sphere. For a regular surface, your electric flux is this. The summation of vector E times the derivative of vector A, which is equals to charge over E naught. Let's have an example. A uniform electric field of a magnitude E is equals to 100 newton per coulomb, which exists in the space of x direction. Calculate the flux of this field through a plane square area of edge 10 centimeters place in the YZ plane. Take the normal along the positive x-axis to be positive. So for our solution, the flux is equal to electric field times area cosine theta. Since our theta here is equal to zero and A is equal to S squared for the area of the square, since we are talking about square. Therefore, by substitution, your electric field is 100 newton per coulomb. You will convert your area into meters. So you have 0.10 meters. 10 centimeters is equal to 0.10 meters raised to the power of 2, since your area is equals to S squared for the area of square. By calculation, you have now 1 Newton meter squared per column. Okay? So, you use this expression of magnetic flux because your theta is equal to 0. And your area is the area of the square. Okay? It's time, it's your turn to practice. A disk of a radius 0.10 meters is oriented with the normal unit vector n, which is at 30 degrees, to a uniform electric field of magnitude 2.0 times 10 to the power of 3 Newton per column. What is the electric flux through the disk? It's your time to solve and to shine. That's all for now. Hopefully, nakatulong po sa inyo ang maiksing video lesson na ito. At kung bago ka sa channel ni Sir Fox, don't forget to hit the subscription button and the notification bell para updated ka sa mga susunod ko pong video lesson. Marami pong salamat. Happy learning, everyone.